I played for you 10 versions of Boston's More Than a Feeling, I could tell you which one was my record. Kiss Alive 1 and Kiss Alive 2.
Abbey Road by the Beatles.
Like an old Led Zeppelin one of my dad's.
Danny Brown's old. He's like a rapper. He's like a kind of a crazy guy. It's good stuff.
If you look around me, how can I say just this is my favorite album? It's just near impossible.
And I played those records over and over and over and over and over and over again.
Vinyl records have been entertaining music fans for decades. From the youngest fan to the oldest, it's hard to not find something to like about the big plastic disc held by a paper sleeve with elaborate artwork on it. Since the advent of CDs and digital music, vinyl should have been phased out, just like the 8-track or cassette. But it wasn't. Vinyl is still alive and well, and you can find lots of it at your local record store.
When I opened, it was the store opened in July of 2005, so going on 9 years now. It's crazy. I was 26. And the history behind it, there's not really too much history. I liked the book by Nick Hornby called High Fidelity.
One day I walked into a record store called The Record Collector that was on Laylor Street in Trent, New Jersey. The owner of the store, his name was Tom Giroldi, his father had passed away and he was inheriting his father's business, which was an upholstery business, and he wanted to get rid of the Record Collector. And I bought it. It just seemed like the right thing to do at the time, and I've been doing it for 35 years.
What drew me to it was just the fact that I wanted to be surrounded by my hobby. I wanted to work in my hobby, which was, we not only sell CDs and, you know, music, we sell DVDs, movies, and some video games even too. And the fact that it was all cheap and it was all right there, and like, here's a whole story. There's no washing machines or there's no like lame books over in the corner. Like, I mean, I like bookstores too, but there's nothing lame in this store. Like, there's just like, it's a huge hobby contained in one like small space, and I really enjoyed the idea of being surrounded by that.
There are loads of reasons why people are still attached to vinyl today. Some people grew up with them and enjoy the memories that they bring. But even younger people are finding reasons to spend money on vinyl instead of digital downloads.
There's something classic about it. There's something, you know, kind of vintage, and, you know, listening to albums how people originally listened to them. Like, if putting on the Ramones' first record, you know, on a turntable and letting the needle spin kind of makes you feel like you're back then in 1976, you know, hearing that record for the first time. And
I think that people are catching on. A lot of people buy them for collectibles now. I see more and more bands all the time including vinyl in their merch.
But I did have one fella come in, and he had a whole bunch of, you know, records that he was buying. And he did volunteer this information. He said, "Sir, I want you to know that I have every one of these albums on my iPad. I have all of them." He says, "But me and my buddies like to get together on the weekends. We bring over a few albums, and we play one side, you know. We listen to it, then we have to get up, maybe talk, turn it over, and listen to the other side." And then I said, "Wow, that's really something," because that's what we did when we were kids too. So the record itself now is the center of attention.
A lot of kids, they're getting into it. I see a lot of people that are, you know, 18 to 25 year olds, whereas when I opened up in 05, it was not the case. It was more 35 to 55 year olds.
The one thing about today's generation with music is you don't get anything. You know, you buy an MP3 and you have nothing to show for it. It's another song on your iPod or your playlist, but you don't own anything tangible. You own an idea. And if I borrow your iPod and you have 5,000 songs on it, I don't know if you like those songs. I don't know if you bought those songs. I don't know if you listened to those songs. It's just information that's stored on a document. But when you buy a record, you have to physically decide whether or not you want to listen to it. If you want to listen to the B-side, you've got to get up and turn the thing over. So I think part of it's that nostalgia. I think everything from the past is cool.
I remember my dad, when I brought home the first vinyl I got, he was surprised. You know, he didn't even know that it's coming back. So I think even the younger kids around our age now are more aware of its comeback than older people.
Vinyl records produce a sound that's unlike any other medium. Their age shows, making each and every one unique, no matter how it's recorded or played back. At times, they can even work together with digital music for a combined experience.
I'm in a band that's called Noro. In January, we're planning on releasing a 4-song EP, and we're gonna do it on vinyl. It's a 7-inch vinyl, because people who don't even have record players can still buy the vinyl as a collectible. And we're gonna put an MP3 card in there, so if they don't have a record player, if they wanna put it on their iPod, it makes it that much easier.
Yeah, when I do buy records now, I digitize them. I turn them all into MP3s, and so I'll listen to vinyl via the digital technology.
It's apples and oranges. I think if you're looking for a little bit of a live kind of making you feel like you're in the room kind of feel, then I think vinyl is a good medium that kind of gets that across. But if you're looking for everything to sound exactly right and, you know, everything in its place, everything to the numbers, you know, exact, then I think CDs and MP3s definitely have that going on.
Sounds warmer and it sounds unique. And what I mean by unique is if I played for you 10 versions of Boston's More Than a Feeling, I could tell you which one was my record. I know it by the pops, the hisses, the scratches. I just know it's mine because everyone sounds different. And that's what I mean by there's a warmth to it. When you listen to a CD, when you listen to an MP3 file, it always sounds the same. It will sound the same from the first time you play it to the last time, and your version and my version are indistinguishable, which is actually better sound quality.
Because when you put on your iPod, or, you know, you're making your own download for you, it's for you. It's not something that you share. You can share it, but it's not the same. I mean, you say, hey, listen, come over to my house and let's listen to all the songs that I downloaded. It's lame-o.
So many people that go into the stores and they buy, like, Lady Gaga's newest record on vinyl, which, I mean, it's your money, do what you want, but it was recorded digitally, and I don't really see the point in, you know, listening to that on vinyl. It sounds perfect because it's produced perfect.
Every music fan has different ways that they love listening to music, but digital music is always on the rise. So is vinyl going anywhere anytime soon?
There's still going to be that group of people who want the old, you know, classic thing, who want the real albums. Like if they hear about an album from the 60s or the 70s and they don't just want to download it, or they don't just want to buy the, you know, 1980s or 1990s CD reissue.
A lot of young people especially will come in and they'll just buy all these records. There's new artists that come out with new records now, completely brand new. There's older artists that get reissued on brand new vinyl, sold brand new, completely brand new from the factory.
You're going to see they're pressing more and more vinyl, and you have young kids that are involved in it.
There's always going to be something with vinyl that is going to be appealing to the audience, I think. You know, I hope.
I keep all my records. I have every record that I ever bought that wasn't stolen. And I'll buy them and I'll catalog them and I keep them. Even though I don't play them, they're still a very important part of who I am and always will be.
The Voyager, I think it is, the spaceship Voyager, it's left the our solar system now. It's been out there for 35 some years. And what medium did they decide to put in the Voyager to tell people in outer space about us, but a record player and a record? Now, the record is not made of plastic, it's made of a metal. But it's a record. Pull it out, turn it up, put your favorite song. That smile, I've been crying to it since I was young. I know there's someone out there feeling just like I feel. I know they're waiting up, I know they're waiting to heal. And I've been holding my breath. Support your local record store, and if you don't have one in your area, open one up.